Emmot's Awakening. Emmot awoke from a troubled sleep, feeling a little sad and a little lonely. It had been a time of feeling removed from others, and so a little lonely. From his garden, Emmot heard the song of a robin. Opening his curtains, he looked out upon the promise of the first day of spring. The sun was shining, the last of winter's snow was melting, and all around, life was awakening. Looking at his cozy, if a little lonely, home, Emmot remembered the robin song and decided a change might be just what he needed. So he left his little home in the highlands and walked far down the valley into the desert.
Night in the desert, the comfort time. By myself, but I know I'm not alone. I reach to the darkness and I pull on your light and I let it walk. Lifting my heart, turning me all around, right over me. Oh, hallelujah. Now let it wash right over me. I walk down this long road, family and friends come to a place that I've never been before. I think on the love of all that's brought me here, and I let it wash right over me, right over me. It's pouring down, lifting my heart, turning me all around, right over me. Oh, hallelujah, I let it wash right over me. Deep in the darkness, no light do I know, and I hear a small voice, it's starting to grow, and like a river reaching the sea, I let it wash right over me, right over me,
right over me.
It's pouring down, lifting my heart,
lifting my heart,
turning me all around, right over me,
right over me.
Oh, hallelujah,
oh, hallelujah,
I let it wash right over me. Yes, I do, I let it wash right over me.
Emmot woke at dawn to the faint sound of voices singing. As he made his way toward them, he heard beautiful harmonies and the sound of children laughing. He came upon a group of people gathered on the riverbank, singing together. Seeing Emmot, one of the group welcomed him to join them. And join them he did.
Take me to the river, drop me in the water. your blessings. Lay your hands upon my head. Just take me to the river. Drive me in the water. Let me feel your blessings. Lay your hands upon my head. Today the day broke golden. Sing glory, hallelujah. The angels come a-calling just to see how you are. So take me to the river. Drop me in the water. Let me feel your blessings. Lay your hands upon my head. Take me to the river. Drop me in the water. Let me feel your blessings. Lay your hands inside my heart. Children came to see me to ask about tomorrow. They wondered, would it be here? And if it was worth their time. There's so much I could tell them, but still they just have to find it out. But I wish that I could reach out and take all their hurt away. So take me to the river and drop me in the water. Let me feel your blessings. Lay your hands upon my head. Take me to the river and drop me in the water. Let me feel your blessings. Lay your hands inside my heart. Calling, yes they do, just to see how you are. So take me to the river, drop me in the water. Let me feel your blessings. Lay your hands upon my head. Take me to the river, drop me in the water. Let me feel your blessings. Lay your hands inside my heart.
Emmot broke bread with his new friends, and as a few of them prepared to leave, they invited Emmot to join them as they spent a beautiful spring afternoon traveling down the river in their boat of many colors.
Sailing down my golden river, sun and water are my own,
and I was never alone.
Life and death are all my
own, and I was never alone.
I was sailing.
Golden sparkles in the
fall. highway. Suddenly I've seen it all.
And I was never alone.
As the sun began to set behind the hills, Emmot bid farewell to his new friends and journeyed home. Having spent a glorious day, once again feeling part of spring's great awakening, he was eager to get back to his normal, blessed life. For a while, Robin Williams said, "Spring is nature's way of saying, let's party." Tolstoy said, "Spring is the time of plans and projects."
What becomes of the rain? Watch it fall down so hard. A little while later, it ain't nowhere to be found. What becomes of the night? She comes on so strong sometimes. Wake in the morning, look and she's gone. Hard to believe, but it's recordable fact. Once something is gone, it don't ever come back. So what becomes of my heart when you're not around? You know it ain't good for nothing. Just a waste of an hour. And what becomes of the sparrow and the song that she sings? You know I sure like to hear it and the hope that it brings. Hard to believe, but it's recordable fact. Once something is gone, it don't ever come back. So what becomes of the rain? I watch it fall down so hard. A little while later, it ain't nowhere to be found. Of my heart when you're not around. Still it ain't good for nothing. It's just a waste of an hour. And what becomes of the sparrow and the song that she sings? You know I sure do miss it and the hope that it brings. You know I sure do. That's right.
Emmot woke from a deep and peaceful sleep to the song of a robin outside his window. Smiling, he rose to welcome the day. There was much to do. Invitation by Mary Oliver. Oh, do you have time to linger for just a little while out of your busy and very important day for the goldfinches that have gathered in the field of thistles for a musical battle to see who can sing the highest note or the lowest or the most expressive of mirth or the most tender? Their strong, blunt beaks drink the air as they strive melodiously, not for your sake, and not for mine, and not for the sake of winning, but for sheer delight and gratitude. Believe us, they say. It is a serious thing just to be alive on this fresh morning in the broken world. I beg of you, do not walk by without pausing to attend to this rather ridiculous performance. It could mean something. It could mean everything. Spring by Mary Oliver. Somewhere a black bear has just risen from sleep and is staring down the mountain. All night, in the brisk and shallow restlessness of early spring, I think of her. Her four black fists flicking the gravel, her tongue, like a red fire, touching the grass, the cold water. There is only one question: how to love this world. I think of her rising like a black and leafy ledge to sharpen her claws against the silence of the trees. Whatever else my life is, with its poems and its music and its glass cities, it is also this dazzling darkness coming down the mountain, breathing and tasting. All day I think of her, her white teeth, her wordlessness, her perfect love. Such Singing in the Wild Branches by Mary Oliver. It was spring, and finally I heard him among the first leaves. Then I saw him clutching the limb in an island of shade, with his red-brown feathers all trim and neat for the new year. First I stood still and thought of nothing. Then I began to listen. Then I was filled with gladness, and that's when it happened. When I seemed to float, to be myself, a wing or a tree, and I began to understand what the bird was saying. And the sands in the glass stopped for a pure white moment, while gravity sprinkled upward, like rain rising, and in fact it became difficult to tell just what was this was singing. It was the thrush for sure, but it seemed not a single thrush, but himself and all his brothers, and also the trees around them, as well as the gliding, long-tailed clouds in the perfectly blue sky. All of them were singing. And of course, yes, so it seemed, so was I. Such soft and solemn and perfect music doesn't last for more than a few moments. It's one of those magical places wise people like to talk about. One of the things they say about it that is true is that once you've been there, you're there forever. Listen, everyone has a chance. Is it spring? Is it morning? Are there trees near you? And does your own soul need comforting? Quick, then. Open the door and fly on your heavy feet. The song may already be drifting away.
Here comes the sun.